This is my student, Funmi, who's gonna take a class with me today. And we're gonna make a pie, a very easy, open-faced, rustic pie. And I'm gonna use some of the fresh fruits of the summer. You know, they call them the stone fruits, but really, I'm using white peaches and maybe a couple of apricots. I did make the dough. I made a homemade dough. You can buy it, okay? Okay. So we're gonna start right here with the dough. I've already made it yesterday, brought it to room temperature. I started to roll it out and I used two pieces of wax paper, which is easy because then the dough doesn't stick to it. I want this to be a little bit larger in diameter. So I'm gonna take it, hopefully, and you kind of have to work fast a little bit. If you make homemade dough, I suggest that you freeze it kind of in a disc so that that's not that much rolling. I'm almost there now. I want it to be a little bit. And you know, if it's irregular, it's fine. It doesn't have to be perfectly round. So I think this be as good as it is.
It's beautiful.
Two pieces. I'm going to stick the whole thing in the refrigerator just to keep it cool, and we'll be right back for the fruit. I got this a couple of days ago and they were kind of hard, so I put them in a brown paper bag and I think they're perfect. So I already just took a cut right around and I'm gonna let you slice it, okay? So perfect is this, when this is how it should be happen. And then we're gonna do, I think, an apricot or two, we'll see as we go along. Now see if that opens up for you. Just give it a twist.
Pretty easy.
Yeah. And that's why they call it fruits. So we'll remove the pits. Just pull it out with your hand. You take that one out.
So how did you kind of decide when if it was ripe enough or not?
Well, you know, it's always a smell, and it gives a little bit when it's hard. Like one of these is so hard that it's got to be kind of half ripe because then the flavor will come out. Okay. So this one, I'm going to let you start just this, not too thin. Cut them that size, and okay. I'll get the pit out for you here.
Okie dokie.
If the pit doesn't come out of the peach like so, I just give it a little bit of help with a knife and pull it out. That's perfect. Oh, these smell so good.
They smell really good.
You're ready to eat?
So ready.
Yeah. The dough is ready to be loaded with this gorgeous fruit, and I peeled off the wax paper. It's sitting on parchment paper, which is a nice thing to have, parchment paper. It just saves you a lot of headache. So now we're gonna place some of this beautiful fruit on. Why don't I tell you what, you grab some of the peaches and just load it around like so. We're gonna leave an edge around because we're gonna fold it up.
Okay.
And while you're finishing that, I always make myself a little bottle of cinnamon and sugar because you don't know when you need it, like on toast or something. Mm-hmm. So you make it as sweet as you want. So this goes with fruit. So I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of this. There we go. And then what I do is sugar. We need sugar for the caramelization. And you might think it's a lot, but it isn't. It brings out the fruit. And if you're worried about sugar, then you don't eat this. And for the little bit of juice that comes out of it, I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of flour. Not a lot.
What does the flour do?
It sort of absorbs some of the juices. We're gonna fold this up. Look, very easy. I usually take a spatula because of the warmth of my hand. So I'll start this and maybe let you finish it. How about that? It's going to be so beautiful no matter what you do. But you kind of want to make the pleats uniform.
Yeah.
And the second time you do it, you'll love it. It's so easy.
A little bit of practice.
Yes. And practice on anything. I mean, apples, whatever you want.
Yeah. And the last one over here.
Perfect. Okay, now we're going to take this egg washer and make a little bit of more of a golden brown.
Okay.
This is the magic. I put an egg yolk with a little bit of milk, and this not a lot because you don't want scrambled eggs. You just want to pink it gently like so.
Okay.
And kind of go fast.
Okay.
You do that. Doesn't have to be careful. Just not too much.
Not too much.
But make sure you get all of it.
Okay.
And it'll drip down. Okay. That's right. Okay, and the last touch, my oven is already heated. I have a convection oven, and this will cook for only about 45 minutes. That's perfect, we're done. Because you, like I said, you don't want too much. Then I take a little sugar, and I sprinkle, I'll do this because I'll sprinkle a little on each side, and when the sugar begins to bleed in the cooking,
okay,
you'll get that wonderful golden crust. Okay, we're done.
That looks beautiful, I'm excited. Yeah?
Okay. So here it goes into the oven for about 40 minutes. We'll check it.
Okay.
You know what, Funmi? I can't wait to open it because you can smell.
You can smell
the peaches delicious. And everything. So here we go. Okay. Look how well you did. Look how gorgeous this is.
That looks amazing.
Yeah. So you can cool it. You know, we have to cool it for at least 20 minutes because it's too hot. Or perhaps, you know, you can also freeze it. For another day, we have guests, and another day, all you do is bake, see? And she did wonderfully well. Here, you should be proud of yourself.
I'm so proud, I'm
okay.
Really excited.
Okay, well, then we'll put it down on the plate, and bye, we're gonna eat.